Hey there, math detectives. Ever tried to break a number down into its building blocks? That's what factors are all about. Get ready for some factor finding fun.
Doodly doodle, doodly doodle, doodly doodles and digits. Area, symmetry, fractions too, it's all here for you.
All right, so what are factors?
Factors are numbers that multiply together to make another number. Another definition could be that a factor is a number that divides exactly into another number, meaning without remainders. Look at this example here. If we are talking about the number 8, the factors of the number 8 are 1 and 8, and 2 and 4. Here's another example. Let's look at the factors of 12. 1 times 12 equals 12, 2 times 6 equals 12, and 3 times 4 equals 12. So the factors of 12 are 1, 2, 3, 4, 6, and 12.
Where do we see factors in real life?
We see factors in real life all the time. They're really helpful when we need to divide things equally, arrange objects, even in music with rhythm and determining how many beats and measures are in a song, and planning events. How many chairs need to be at each table? How many tables do we need? Factors are everywhere around us.
Why are factors important?
Factors are important because they often are used in real life situations like what we just mentioned, but they are also really important to understand because they help us understand more complex math concepts that you will learn, such as simplifying fractions, prime numbers, greatest common factors, and least common multiples. Those topics we will discuss in another video. Today, let's just focus on factors.
How do we find the factors of a number?
There are a few different ways that we can find factors of a number. The three ways that we will go over today are using factor rainbows, using a factor T-chart, and using tools like using a multiplication chart. Try to find a strategy that works best for you. One way that you can find factor pairs or factors of a number is using factor rainbows. We call them factor rainbows because the line you're going to draw between the two pairs of factors kind of looks like a rainbow. Let's make a factor rainbow for this number here.
Let's do the number 18. I always start with the number 1. All numbers have 1 as a factor. What times 1 equals 18? 18! Now I go on to the next number, which is 2. 2 times what equals 18? 9. All right, let's go on to the number 3 to see if it's a factor of 18. 3 times what equals 18? 6. Let's try the number 4. No, there is nothing times 4 that is a whole number that equals 18. What about 5? 5 is also not a factor. 7? 7 is also not a factor. 8? Nope. 8 is also not a factor. So our factors of 18 are 1, 2, 3, 6, 9, and 18.
Another way that we can find factors or factor pairs is using a factor T-chart. Here is what a factor T-chart looks like. Let's make a factor T-chart using the number 30.
Remember, 1 is a factor of all numbers. So 1 times 30 equals 30. Let's go on to 2. 2 times what equals 30? 15. 3 times 10 equals 30, so they're both factors. All right, let's think about the number 4. Can 4 evenly go into the number 30? No, so 4 is not a factor. How about 5? Yes, 5 times 6 equals 30. So our factors of 30 are 1, 30, 2, 15, 3, 10, 5, and 6.
Another tool that you can use is a multiplication chart. Look at this multiplication chart right here. This is a great tool because you can look on the multiplication chart to see what factors go into the number we're trying to find. For example, let's take the number 20. We're going to try to find 20 on the multiplication chart. Ah, here it is. These are two factors of 20. Here it is again. These are also two factors of 20. Do you see how a multiplication chart can be a helpful tool? Now that I showed you how to find factors in a few different ways, let's try to find all the factors of 32 together.
I'm going to use the rainbow technique. I'm going to start with 1. 1 times 32 equals 32. 2 times 16 equals 32. 3, it's not a factor. 4, yes, 4 times 8 equals 32. Let's try 5, not a factor. 6, not a factor. 7, also not a factor. So the factors of 32 are 1, 2, 4, 8, 16, and 32.
Let's see if you can find the factors of these numbers on your own. Can you find all the factors of 40?
Remember, you can pause this video to have as much time as you need to solve. I'm going to use a T-chart strategy to show my thinking. All right, 40. What are the factors of 40? We're going to start with 1. 1 times 40 equals 40. All right, let's go on to 2. 2 times what equals 40? 20. Is 3 a factor?
Yay.
3 is not a factor of 40. What about 4? 4 times 10 equals 40. 5? 5 times 8 equals 40. So the factors of 40 are 1, 40, 2, 20, 4, 10, 5, and 8. Did you get it correct?
Can you find all the factors of 25?
I'm going to use a multiplication chart to help me solve this. Look, 25, the two factors are 5 and 5. So 25 actually only has 3 factors, 1 times 25 and 5 times 5. So the factors of 25 are 1, 5, and 25.
What strategies did you use? Which strategies do you prefer?
Find more videos and other information at doodleslearning.com.